Good morning from the Florida Everglades. We are on our annual Florida duck hunt. I got my dad out here and I got my brother Jed behind the camera. We're about 30 minutes till legal shoot. We just set up at our spot and we're hoping to have a great morning out here. You excited?
I'm excited. There's a lot of cool things about duck hunting. A simple, cool thing ever since I was a kid is opening a box of shotgun shells. And they just feel so neat in your hand. You know, they make this little sound when the brass touches, and that's just putting tingles down my spine. I don't know. There's just so many little things about duck hunting that I love.
How about you, Jen?
There's no wind out here. I think that's a good sign. Hopefully they're flying and we can knock them down.
Okay, let's get ready to go. Oh my gosh.
Well, didn't that make a cool sound, Brett?
That wasn't good.
Listen to those things.
Well, I accidentally just dropped my whole box of shells in the bag, but I am filling up my hi-see waders here. Got a nice little pocket in there I'm pretty short. So having a nice pocket inside so that your shells don't get wet is pretty convenient. But we're gonna fill up, tuck in the canoe into the reeds so that the ducks can't see it, and then we're gonna set up in our spots and get ready for the sun to come up.
You know, one of us can go to one side of her and one of us can go to the other side of her. You pick.
Tell the people about my spot.
Well, Brooke has a habit of letting ducks fly over, and I'll say, Brooke, why didn't you shoot? And she'll just say, I don't know. So we're gonna give her the point, which is the prime spot. But I told her, if she doesn't shoot, she's gonna have to forfeit that spot to Jed, because he will shoot. So we'll see if she lets him fly by or she's gonna pull the trigger today.
Hopefully I shoot today. So wish me luck, guys. All right, legal shoot. I thought you said one landed in the decoys, Jen.
I think it just flew in front of it.
Get ready, people are shooting.
I'm ready.
Here comes three.
Jet out in front of us.
To your right, get him. Here comes one, a single, to the right, a single.
In front of you, Jed.
There goes four more.
Shoot. There goes two, that direction.
Those four we should have shot at.
They're flying faster than they were last year. Did you hear that?
I heard it, but I didn't see it.
Me neither.
Certainly more than one duck. It was so loud. All them teals up high.
Coming at us. How did we all three miss that?
I should have got that one. That was a good shot.
Here comes one more left, though. Real low. You want to shoot it?
In the water?
Yeah. You want to shoot it?
Got him.
Yeah.
Is that a duck right there, Dad?
Where?
Up top. High.
Yep.
Up high, Jed. Right above us.
Son of a gun.
There we go. First duck of the morning. Blue winged teal. Look at that gorgeous sunrise. Incredible. Look at that sunrise. Beautiful. Up high again, Dad.
Yeah. I think they were too high.
Do you see how gorgeous the sunrise is, Jen?
Oh, yeah.
I'm sorry I missed those ones straight up. I took 3 shots at that duck.
At least you got an excuse with your new contacts.
No, my gun is malfunctioning. It's hard as hell to load. You can shoot 2 times and there won't be one in the chamber.
That sounds like user error.
No. If you have 3 shells and you shoot 2 times and there's not one in your chamber, you can't shoot the 3rd time.
How do you feel about the spot now that the sun is up?
I like it. I think we missed some opportunities. There's a low flyer out there to the right. I don't know if it'll come our way.
Out in front of us, Dad. Low. Jed, you see him?
Don't move. Those flared, didn't they?
They're coming back. They landed over there.
They were coming right at us.
Up high, Dan.
Yep. I'd be happy with 1 mallard. The best eaten duck out here. Snail kite? Yep. That was a nice shot of that snail kite, wasn't it?
He didn't even see us.
Looking too good at 1 duck here, Brook. Not looking too good.
I'm not giving up yet.
Single duck to the right. Coming our way, Brook. Get ready.
The weather is beautiful too, huh?
Oh, it's been gorgeous.
There comes a teal.
Baby.
About time.
Nice job, Dad.
Thanks. Boy, it was coming right in for me.
Yeah.
You could have shot too.
I was about to pull the trigger. I almost went to reload my gun after you shot because I was so sure that I had shot.
No way.
I was literally about to pull the trigger and then you shot it. I literally went to grab a shell to reload. That's how much I thought I had shot. I'm gonna just go get it. Cause she's blowing.
I think that one's a drake.
Gorgeous, Dad.
Jed, there's something loose about my gun. Good.
That does not look good.
No.
Well, my dad and I both have blue winged teals. You got a drake and I got a hen.
Something loose about my gun, I don't know.
What does that mean?
It's like coming apart.
Your gun is coming apart.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like his stock is coming off.
Oh, a flamingo.
What?
Either that or a roseate spoonbill.
Oh my gosh, it's beautiful.
It's a roseate spoonbill.
Wow. That thing is pink, huh? I want one of those big flocks to come in, huh? And we each get like 2 or something. Wouldn't that be nice?
We walked all the way out here, didn't we?
Practically.
You did. I was a passenger princess. There's water, but there's not much of it. It's like it seems deep, you know, like it's up to like almost my hips, but there's just so much mud also.
Yeah.
There goes the flamingo.
This feels pretty good. This is how I shot my duck too, this position. My gun's on my leg.
No wonder your gun's falling apart, it's in the water.
I have a synthetic stock. Jed has a wooden stock.
I mean, you look comfortable.
And he used to hold his this much in the water when he was little. And the whole bottom of the gun would swell up.
I don't ever have the back of my gun in the water, but occasionally
there went two.
My barrel will be touching the water.
Here comes Dad.
I thought you had it.
I've had a fish slap my leg like 3 times today.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
What kind of fish?
I don't know.
Did you see it?
No, I just feel it. I guess because I'm like stirring stuff up.
That's so weird. Whoa. My gun just jammed also.
What?
My gun just jammed also.
Did it?
The chamber didn't close properly. The shell was stuck.
Brooke, did you even shoot at that one?
Whoa, what was that?
Probably a gar. Brooke, here it comes again. It's gonna be... Get wrecked.
Holy smokes.
Nice job. Boom, boy.
Come on, boys, let's get a few more of those. We're gonna have Christmas duck dinner. Christmas duck appetizers. I'm gonna get it, Jed, because it's blowing.
Thank you.
Was blowing. There we go. We all three got a teal. There we go. 3 bluings.
Are we gonna get stormed on? It usually gets cold just before the rain.
Looks like it might.
Huh?
I said it looks like it might. But we only do this once a year. I think it might start raining on us here soon. It's definitely looking like it's raining out there and it might be coming this way. Uh-oh. This rain is cold, huh?
One straight ahead, Brooke. Coming at us. I'm killing it.
How much for you killing it?
Yeah.
Man, Jed.
That looked like a shoveler.
They got him.
Oh, they did get him.
Yep. Coming around, Dad. Come on.
Oh, wow.
Nice job, Jed.
Did you see that one, Brooke?
Yeah.
Were you gonna shoot?
Yes, I was all lined up.
You were?
Yes, I was. There'll be even video evidence of it.
Did you get to reload your gun? Oh, Brooke, we're on the right same spot.
Coming from behind you, Dad. You're going through some shells today, huh?
Yeah.
I inflated your head by saying you only needed 6 today.
I'm running low.
If I keep shooting like that.
Pretty cocky last night.
Yeah.
21,
That's all I need.
It took me a while to get dialed in. I still don't think I'm dialed in. Frick, the fish has touched my leg 6 times.
How come you can't see it?
I think I'm just stirring stuff up and he's eating it. But he'll like slap me with his tail.
So crazy. I got it.
Oh, you did?
No.
Unload on him.
My gun did the same thing again.
I'm down to my last 2 shells.
I must have not, reloaded at one time. Whoops! All blue winged teals.
I'm out.
You want to shoot my gun?
I can?
Yeah. There comes one right at you. No?
He turned around.
Huh?
He turned around right when you said my name.
People are shooting, man.
People are shooting, man.
Yeah, man.
Stay vigilant.
Hey, man. People are shooting.
We may not be able to see the skyline over there anymore, but people are still shooting. Over there, clear. There, rain.
We got some 3 in front of a truck. See them? Up high. Straight out. Keep an eye on them, Dad, on the left. See them?
No.
You can always count on Jed to call out the birds that are 3 miles away.
You do the same thing. Because they're like, look at that flock of 800 40 miles away.
That's because I'm admiring them. Oh, they just got one over there. That's the first time I've actually seen them shoot one.
Is that a high flyer coming our way?
Way. I was going to compliment you on not sky busting today, but...
Too late.
Yeah. Too late.
Now what time is it?
10:06. How long do you think it's going to take us to pack up and leave, Dad?
An hour and a half to get out of here. I think we should leave at 10:30.
Cut, Brooke, come in from the right. I did. That's what I was talking about. Up front.
Alright guys, we are winding down our duck hunt. We ended up with a total of 5 blue winged teals. And before we clean up all of our spent shells, as well as our decoys, I'm going to tell you a little bit about today's video sponsor, which is Hi-C. Hi-C is the waders that I'm wearing right now. I've worn these in Oregon while steelhead fishing, as well as duck hunting here in Florida. They've kept me bone dry, they're extremely comfortable, and they've kept me warm. Now, not only does Hi-C make waders like this, as well as a bunch of different other kinds of waders, but they also make a bunch of different kind of boots. Whether you're looking for hiking boots, cowboy boots, rubber boots, work boots, you name it, they got it. Another item that I absolutely love from them is their deck boots that I wear while fishing on the boat. If you guys have ever seen one of my fishing videos before, you know I always wear boots on the boat. It keeps your feet nice and dry all day, as well as when you're catching things like wahoo and kingfish, and those toothy fish are coming in the boat, it keeps your feet nice and safe so you don't have any accidents. So if you guys are interested in checking out Hi-C, whether you're looking for some waders...
That I think we got. Oh, we cracked it again. Oh, look, there's another one. Brooke, I should have handed you your gun.
Can you get it, Jed?
Shoot it, Jed. Look at them all flying. Look, another one just flew by.
We had some live action there in the middle of our integration. Judge just got another one. So that is 6 blue-winged teals for the day.
There goes another one.
So Hi-C has a 100% warm and dry guarantee, as well as a lifetime warranty on their products. So if you guys are interested in trying them out, you can go to Hi-C.com, or I will have a link in the description to all of my favorite items. And you guys can save 15% with code BROOK15. Now, let's see if we can get a couple more ducks before our hunt ends today.
That was crazy.
One of them cracked on the corner.
You always want to make sure you pick up all of your spent shells before you leave. So Dad, how was your hunt today?
It was nice. I always always happy to get out here in the slough with my kids and nature, and it's just we don't get to pull as many permits as we'd like, but just every time you get out here, it's special.
It was a good day. It rained on us a little bit. I definitely didn't get dialed in, even at the end there, probably. Normally I go to shoot clays like once a year to stay fresh, and I didn't do that. So I was off my game. I think I shot like 30 shells for 4 birds. Outside of that, it was a great day.
So sometimes when we're out here, the water is pretty deep, and sometimes it's not as deep. And today is one of those days where the water is not very deep, so we cannot just paddle through all this water here, even though it looks like the water is pretty deep. It's mud up until like 3 inches from the top, so it's really hard to walk through. But this morning, we attempted paddling, it didn't work, and so my dad and Jed got out and walked and pushed the canoe. And they are so kind because they just let me sit here in the canoe as they pull me along the way. I'm just the passenger princess today. Right, Jen?
Someone's got to do it.
I said, is it harder to pull the canoe when I'm sitting in it, or is it more just like annoying to have to walk? And they said it's more annoying to just have to walk, so hopefully they weren't just lying and saying that. And
wait, look, my foot is stuck in the mud. And you gotta use the canoe to pull your foot out of the mud with each step.
Like, look at all this junk. It's just sticks and mud. Hard to walk through. Well, we had a pretty fun day out here. We ended up shooting 6 blue-winged teals. We saw a lot of other birds fly by today, but you know, we haven't had much practice, so we were missing a little bit today, but that's okay. We still had a lot of fun. You know, it's a real treat when we get to come out here and do this, especially when we get to bring some home to have for dinner, because we only do it about once a year. So I'm excited to cook those ducks up. I have no idea how I'm going to do it yet, but it's only 2 days till Christmas, so maybe like an appetizer on Christmas Day or something like that.
Duck poppers.
My dad says duck poppers. So maybe we'll do like a little duck popper appetizer for Christmas. We'll see. I gotta think of something. So yeah, we'll see you back at home. I am very thankful to have these guys pull me around in this canoe. This is not the same way we went, but it's opening up.
Hey guys, welcome back to the kitchen. So my dad requested duck poppers and that is what I am making tonight. I've already started wrapping up some of my duck breasts here with some beautiful thick applewood bacon. But basically what I did was I got my duck breasts in this bowl and they've been marinating in some Italian dressing for about 3 hours now. They probably will be better if you had the time to marinate them for longer, but I didn't really think about doing that in time. The outside of them kind of has turned gray, but what I did was I like butterflied them and the inside is all still pure red. So I think that marinade would probably have penetrated in a little bit further the longer you marinate these. But what I'm doing is I got some cream cheese over here that I've sliced up and I'm kind of just shaping it a little bit to the shape of the duck breast. And then I have some sliced jalapeno peppers.
Sliced tamed jalapeno peppers.
Yes, sliced tamed. It says that they're medium heat. I feel like I usually do mild heat with them. So I'm a little bit nervous because if you guys know me, I am a big baby when it comes to heat. So I'm praying they're not too hot. I didn't even try one, but Victor tried and he said that it's perfect for me. So yeah, put in a couple peppers in there. And then what I did was I took my toothpicks and I've had them sitting in a cup of water now for probably about 30 minutes because I'm gonna grill these. And toothpicks usually burn on the grill, so we're trying to prevent that slightly by letting them soak in some water.
Show us how you do that crisscross applesauce right there. Look at that.
Just kind of wrap that baby up, nice and safe, ready for the grill. So we had shot 6 ducks, so we got 12 breasts. So we're cooking them all tonight. This is a little bit of a labor of love. Told everyone we'd be eating in about 30 minutes. It's kind of taking longer than I thought, so make sure you give yourself enough time. But 2, 3, however many of those you want, tuck them in. Bacon and just wrap to the best of your abilities. I was standing in the bacon aisle for quite some time because there was buy one get one free bacon, but it was very, very thin. And I normally don't turn down a buy one get one free, but I was like, that bacon looks way too thin. And I'm very glad I went with a thicker cut bacon because I think this would be a disaster trying to wrap these up with thin bacon. So get yourself some thick bacon. So today is Thursday. We went duck hunting on Saturday. And the second we got home on Saturday, I took those duck breasts and I put them in a bowl of water with some thick, like flaky salt in there. And I've left that in that water and I left it at my parents' house and every couple days, they take it out and they change the water out with the salt. And what that's doing is that's getting the blood out of your meat. You're seasoning your meat so it's gonna stay nice and juicy when you cook it, as well as it's gonna get out some of that gamey flavor. Blue-winged teals are a very delicious duck. You don't really hear anyone put their nose up to a blue-winged teal, but sometimes, you know, like diver ducks and things like that, people will say that they don't like those ones so much. But if you are not properly taking care of your ducks, you might have that really strong gamey flavor. So try brining your duck meat before you cook it. Don't just clean it and throw it in the freezer. Brine it, take care of your meat so that you can enjoy it. You don't wanna just try to cook it up and not get out all that blood because it is a very bloody meat. So just take care of it and then hopefully you will enjoy it more. I know you will. Well, here are all of our ducks ready for the grill.
Mm.
We got a little bit of flames going on, but that's expected since we got bacon grease going down. Right, time to take these babies off. Woo! Lost a pepper.
Don't leave that there.
Sorry, little guy. Here we go. Let's go try them. They look delicious. Alright guys, so here is our finished product. We got our beautiful duck poppers. I am so excited to try them. And I did make some other side dishes as well as some chicken, so this is just a little appetizer. Here you go, Mom. Take one and give one to Dad.
Brooke and her family go duck hunting usually once or twice a year, and it's always a treat. I don't go with them. They do it as a nice family activity, but eating them is incredible. We eat a lot of fish in this house, but we don't get a lot of game, and a lot of people, Brooke tells me that people kind of turn their nose up to duck, but I think duck is delicious. I kind of like that gamey flavor. I don't find it overwhelming. I really like it, and especially with a recipe like this with jalapenos and cream cheese, and that bacon shields it from getting really dry. I think the brine, like Brooke was saying, makes a big difference. You could taste that saltiness in the duck meat, and it just comes together so well, and that's a real treat since we eat so much seafood to just get something different, you know, a wild resource from Florida. And yeah, I love eating it every single time. Thank you, Brookie.
I always say it, I always prefer it when I'm a part of the catching process and not just the eating process. But we only shot teal, which are like the smallest ducks out there, and so they don't have a ton of meat on them, and we have a really big crew, so as you can see, there was enough for five of us, but normally there's at least eight of us, so that's why I'm gonna have to do some more practicing so I can shoot at least six ducks to feed our huge crew.
What Victor said is true. He says people put their nose up to duck, but he really likes it. One of the reasons he really likes it is because you cook it really well. These duck poppers, I'm not kidding, these duck poppers are the way to eat duck. When I first started duck hunting, we were trying recipe after recipe after recipe, and the ducks were adding up in my freezer. And I told Deb, I said, I guess I'm gonna have to quit duck hunting. And she's like, why? I said, because we don't like to eat duck. We could not find a good recipe. And she tried different recipes. She made duck soup, and that was pretty good. That was one of my favorites. And I'm like, okay, I'll still hunt because I could eat the duck soup. But man, now it's a whole different level of, I really like these duck poppers. I'm telling you, don't give your ducks. So many people will be like, hey, you want my ducks? They want to give their ducks away. Don't give your ducks away. Try this duck popper recipe and you'll be amazed.
Mom, when we pulled up, I could smell something really good, and I said, oh, I hope that's what we're eating. And it was, and I'm really happy she made them this way. I guess she said 4 years ago we had these. Bacon and cream cheese, a favorite, so just delicious. Good job, Brooke. 2000.
Thank you. I was worried that those peppers were going to be a little hot, and they had no heat to them whatsoever. They were like very, very mild peppers. So if you like hot peppers, go for some hotter peppers, because those things were not hot at all, but those were absolutely delicious. Like Jed said,
I need to definitely get my shot a little better because we missed some decent opportunities. And a lot of times I just think that the ducks are too far away and I don't even bother shooting at them. So I'm not gonna lie, I need to go out there more often and have a little more practice so that we can bring home more ducks so that we can feed more people. Luckily, one of the brothers was not here so that we didn't have to share it with more people. But yeah, it was really delicious. Again, if you guys are looking for any kind of boots, new waders, make sure you check out High C. I'll have a link in the description. You guys can save the 15% with my code BROOK15 linked down below. As always, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed and I will see you in the next video.